Okay, I'm gonna give you some pictures, and you have to tell me if you think it's like nature or city. Okay. So here's the first one.
Nature.
Here's the second.
City.
Okay, what do you think of this?
Both? Can I say that?
Are you a country or a city person? Do you like the hustle and bustle of an exhilarating urban scene, or do you crave the quiet serenity of the mountains? Can you enjoy both? And more interestingly, can you enjoy the experience of both in the same place? Timothy Beatley, author of Biophilic Cities, defines a biophilic city as a green city, a city with abundant nature and natural systems that are visible and accessible to urbanites. Biophilic cities certainly revolve around physical conditions and innovative, sustainable urban design. However, they will also be inherently connected with the people, culture, and spirit of a place.
Just the literal image of the greener the city, the more healthy, in practical terms, it's going to be.
Biophilia originated from the Greek word for love of life and was brought to the forefront of environmental conversations when E.O. Wilson realized the negative implications associated with humans' departure from nature and the need to reconnect the two. The concept of biophilia implies that humans hold a biological need for connection with nature on physical, mental, and social levels, and that this connection affects our personal well-being, productivity, and societal relationships. The tension between a city habitat and a country habitat exacerbates the separation both physically and mentally regarding humans' place in nature. Common perceptions of Dickinson students on the topic aren't far off.
Definitely nature.
Nature.
That's nature.
City.
City.
That's a city.
Huh. City.
Why?
I don't know if I would call it nature in a city, but you can definitely put green space and outdoor areas within cities.
Nature is like beyond a boundary of the city.
Cities to most equate to decay, conquest over nature, environmental loss, and overall separation from the natural world.
That's a city.
Why isn't it nature?
Because there are buildings and concrete walls and people walking on a constructed path.
These views must change in order to discuss humans' real place in nature.
I don't think there are any human city dwellers, no matter how urban they want to imagine themselves, who are completely disconnected from the natural world.
For as the number of people living in cities surpasses those living in rural areas, we must more critically consider if the environment is where we live, work, and play, shouldn't the cities be developed as critical environments as well?
If city dwellers are only concerned with life in the city, then I think they turn their back on a very important part of the way to improve urban life. Likewise, if rural dwellers completely turn their back on the city, I think they're making a mistake because of the amount of human resources that the cities have to offer.
You think a city could be nature?
I mean, yeah, there's obviously a reason why they call it the concrete jungle.
A biophilic city puts nature first in its design, planning, and management, recognizing the essential need for daily human contact with nature, as well as the potential ecological and economic services and values provided by the environment. While dreaming about green cities makes us hopeful and feel good inside, are biophilic techniques really viable for the cities of today? Can our cities be retrofitted? And how would a green wall even benefit us?
Historically, we would just come and plant maybe a few trees sort of in parks for aesthetic purposes. Now I think we need to be more conscious about the actual biochemistry of what we're doing in urban spaces. Green roofs are something that A lot of work has been done on, as has work on green walls. Imagine that every pane of glass that we can now see when we're sort of looking at skyscrapers, imagine if all of those were solar collectors.
But even if it looks good in theory and research, a major factor in whether or not biophilic cities are in our future will come down to the inhabitants, the urban species, getting on board.
An important aspect of it is really thinking deeply and talking to people about sort of what's important to them, where are the connections between issues of environmentalism or sustainability to things that they care about. A strong community, a piece of that has to be the physical environment in which they are. Having spaces that are near to where they live or work or shop that have elements of the natural environment accessible there that they can interact with, they get value out of that.
Clearly, biophilic cities will deal with more than just algae-covered walls and increased biodiversity. Culture will determine the success and prosperity. If, as Beatley says, biophilic cities have a spirit, will the inhabitants of city environments have the spirit to make it work?
It's not just a question about humans bringing human and urban life to the natural world. It's about us, those of us who are concerned with the environment, with these issues, realizing the obligation that we have to help bring the forces of nature and the beneficial elements of the natural world back into cities.
Much kind of figuring out sort of, what is it that other people care about, and then genuinely thinking about, all right, how can what I'm interested in connect with and support what they want to do?
E.O. Wilson stated that life around us exceeds in complexity and beauty anything humanity is ever likely to encounter. While he is referring to the natural world, awe-inspiring skyscrapers and the constant exuberance a city exhibits could also be the life around us.
I myself have friends who live in cities who say that they don't care about nature, or that they're not concerned with nature or interested in the natural world. And I try and tell them, or I do tell them, they're breathing the same air that any person on top of a mountain is breathing. They're using the same water. They're deriving their foodstuffs from the same sources.
That paradigm shift of creating and living in a truly biophilic city will take a lot of work politically, environmentally, and socially. Population hubs like our growing cities must be retrofitted. Biophilic cities will work nature beyond its stereotypic borders, bringing people back to it. Walking by a green wall every day, cultivating an urban garden in an old lot, just living within a new type of nature, an urban nature, will hopefully bring back a feeling of stewardship for the environment where it was once perceived to be lost.
Any child flipping over rocks in Central Park is finding the same little creatures underneath those rocks that even the most rural dwellers are finding.
If a connection to nature is hardwired into our DNA, an affiliation for it is part of what makes us human. Nature is not optional, it is essential, and in that sense, it is essential for one of our densest habitats, the city. While it will be hard to judge the success of a biophilic city, creating and inspiring an environmental appreciation and curiosity of a landscape which was once thought of as a biodiversity desert sets the scene for monumental shifts in humans' perception of what truly is nature and how to find our place in it.